The morning special sitting began with the scrutiny of the proposed amendments to the National Intelligence Service Bill, with several members of parliament expressing reservations about the functions of the NIS as spelled out in the bill. A section of members of parliament were uncomfortable with clause 5 of the bill, which stipulates that NIS would undertake security vetting for those seeking to hold vettable positions.
So I would want that they focus their attentions on issues of national security, and if they have any information, that information should go to the police, and if you're gathering any information of that nature, it should be to another agency, but it should not be their sole or primary responsibility.
We are, by making this amendment, taking them away from the arena of politics. They gather information, they give to the police to act.
This is probably one of the bills which was wrongly drafted, giving too much power to one person.
But some supported the clause, saying the NIS will not vet those seeking elective positions.
It's accepted. I mean, that there has to be vetting. And the vetting here today is just to give background information. Who be giving background information, Mr. Chairman? So I think we need to be practical.
Probably the honorable member is mistaking this to mean that you will require a certificate of clearance from NIS. This particular clause does not contemplate a situation whereby you have to be given a certificate of clearance. It simply says confidential information about you is passed over to the vetting authority so that the vetting authority, Mr. Speaker, makes an informed decision.
Of particular concern was that those undergoing security vetting will have to appear before the NIS, and some MPs wanted the provision to be amended to stipulate that the NIS would just submit a confidential report instead of actual vetting.
You don't even be aware. This is a confidential report. It's like a reference letter from your previous employer. The way you get a reference letter, Mr. Chairman. We are confusing issues here.
Vetting by the security agency does not necessarily, does not, in fact, not necessarily, does not include at all interview. But it has to be there, because even those who are serving in the military, everywhere, that are very important, state officers and everybody who has access to critical information to this country has to be vetted. And
provisions of the bill that would allow Parliament to vet the President's nominee for the position of Director General of the NIS drew heated debate. Efforts by the finance minister to give the NSIS Director General security of tenure, as opposed to the 5-year term stipulated in the bill, was declared time barred.